Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to discuss about optimized ribbon in Power BI. What is this option is all about, and once you start using it, what are the advantages you are going to get? Let's try to check it out as part of this video. Before proceeding for the video, if you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So what are the options available as part of this optimized ribbon? Pass visual, optimization presence, apply all styles. I don't want to explain it here. I will head out to my laptop, in the Power BI desktop. Then we will try to understand each one of the options. This channel contains data analytics contents, which is free of cost. You can able to learn SQL, MSBI, SSIS, SSAS, as well as Power BI. Please utilize this free content, share this channel with friends and colleagues. Let's move on to Power BI desktop. So you can see here, this is a simple dashboard and there is options here. This is what pass visual and optimization present is the second option. Then there comes the apply all slices button. So performance apply, analyzer was exist from the long. So let's try to understand one by one about all these options. Let's try to discuss about current behavior of this dashboard, right? So I have started this performance analyzer. Let's stop it and start it from the beginning. You can see, click on the performance analyzer, start recording. So let's click on this red. So you can see here, a set of queries are fired now, right? When I click on it here, then again another set of queries are fired here. Basically, even when you click on it here, there are certain queries being keep on fired, right? For each action over here, the queries are keep on getting fired to get the latest data. But during development, I don't want all these things, right? Let's try to build another table. Instead of this, I will try to add a table here. So let me add a certain currency name and also add a discount. Promotion has a value, class, all other things. So if I keep on adding it like this, so for each change, right, for each change I'm getting certain queries. Let's add another color here. You can see another query is being fired. So this is a costly operation when you are dealing with the direct query or any other source systems, that also involves certain cost, right? So in order to avoid that, because I don't want to see the immediate results as soon as I add a columns. So this is the current architecture of Power BI default behavior. So I can pass this behavior. Let me clear all these things. Let me stop and start recording again. So when I click on pass now, okay, let's try to remove certain visuals from here, right? So I don't want color anymore, I don't want class anymore. But when you click here, there is no queries being fired, okay? And even when you click highlighting here, right, nothing will happen. You can see there is a option available at each visual what it should behave. So whatever you do, even you click on here red and M, so here even though it says like that something is fired, right, there is no queries are being fired, there is some actions happen. So this is the advantage of this particular option, that is pass visual. So you will not have your whatever during your development time, whatever actions you do, each time it will not refresh. And if you want only for this visual, you can check, you can click on individual visual, or you can click on all the visuals, or you can uncheck the past visual by refresh visuals. So this is the option about pass visuals, and you can refresh visual. This is to improve your development time. I remember, like, each measure when you create, even if you create a single measure, entire thing will be refreshed. So these things are unnecessary while during the development. That disadvantage can be overcome by the pass visuals. So this option, while you are developing, click on it and you do all your development, then finally you can refresh visual. That is in simple term. Let's move on to the second option called optimization presence. Optimize presence, that is the our next option. In that we need to choose the query reduction. Now the option says interactivity. So basically this present allows cross highlighting and cross filtering as well as real-time slicer selection, usually best for import mode. And query reduction, this present turns off cross highlighting and cross filtering and adds an apply button to filters, usually best for direct query connections. What it means? See, basically like how the current system behaves is like, let me start recording. When you click on this visual, you can see other visuals also being fired, right? I mean, the queries are being fired. Now, this is the current behavior. This is called cross highlighting, okay? When you click on it, you can see the highlighted value is there and total value is there. So this is called cross highlighting. So when you choose this one, and you can see a new button is added, apply button, okay? When I uncheck this, the apply button is gone, okay? So this is the option they are saying about. So basically when you choose this one, it will not filter any of those, okay? It will not choose any of those over here. Only when you choose, when you click on it, there is no interactivity happens at all, right? But in order to do any interaction, you can still choose certain colors here and then click on OK, then it will fire a single query. So basically if you see here, performance analyzer, start recording, let me click on this, you can see none of the queries will be fired. Basically when you choose the direct query mode, it will be more optimized. I'm still in import mode, that is why you will not see actual behavior here. Right now when you click on blue and black, then apply, then you can see actual query being fired. So this is the behavior, okay, of this optimization presence. Either you can go for query reduction, this is when you use direct query, go for it, there will be apply button and there won't be any interactivity. When you choose import mode, it's better to have an interactivity. This is all about optimization present. Let's move on to last option, that is apply all slicer button. For that I need two slicers over here. Let me add certain slicer here. Let me uncheck the interactivity back to this interactivity again and have color. Okay, then product color, and let me have some product class. There you go. Okay, so again it also somewhat deals with kind of a performance improvement or user experience. Basically this apply all slicers, because you have 5 to 6 slicers in your report, but as soon as you click on each slicer, let me clear it off for you and let me give some space here, you can see as soon as you choose one slicer, immediately you will get certain results. Okay, you can see from this table there is some DAX query has been run, and you can choose multiple option, each time there will be a queries being keep on firing. But as an end user, I'm not interested to see only blue, I want to see all this combination, then only I need the entire result, right? For there is no point in checking each time when I click certain buttons, but I'm not at all interested in it. So And also it is performance deficient, because each time when you click, there is certain queries being fired, you get the answers, but that user is not at all interested. So for this, if you add, right, let me clear it off everything again. If you add apply all slices, right, I can add it here. As soon as you click it here, okay, the slicer is one slicer query is only fired, and also you have these two queries are being fired. That is, no table queries are being fired now. After apply all the slices, then I click on apply all, then only your actual queries are being fired. So this will save your query reduction actually, right? Also the cost obviously. So this option is really good. And then you can come up with, you can ask me like how should I clear, because you might have 6 to 7 buttons, right? So again, choose this one, keep it here, apply all slicer, then let me stop and clear it off. This is just to show you. I'm going to action, then you can see I think it should be clear all slices, then you can rename it as well. Action, and where is that? I think there is some option here. Style, yes, clear. So you can click on it. I need to press control because I'm desktop, so this will clear it off. So again, I want H, blue and L. Unless I press apply all, it will not work. So this will be really cool feature to optimize your reports. I hope I covered all these options which is available in the optimize button. This will definitely improve your query reductions as well as user experience. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data